Hello guys and welcome back to the channel. Now guys, we go back to the Dasuke storyline and it looks as though the people that are weighed against this Dasuke guy are plentiful and powerful. Even elements within the regime that he served are now weighing against him. So it looks as though Malami, the attorney general for the government under Goodluck Jonathan, is now even now weighing against Dasuke. So guys, I bring you this. Dasuke ex AGF Malami faces disciplinary panel over comments against Jonathan's government. So ex-AGF Malami faces disciplinary panel over comments against Jonathan's government. So now here's the body of the story. The immediate past Attorney General of the Federation and Minister of Justice, Abubakar Malami, SAN, will on June 14, 2019, face the disciplinary panel, the Legal Practitioners Privilege Committee, over a prejudicial statement made against the detained former National Security Advisor, Colonel Sambo Dasuke. The hearing notice, signed by a Patricia Oramuru Esquire, the Secretary LPPC Disciplinary Committee, has a reference number. I'm not going to quote you the reference number because it's just a reference number. It reads, "Take notice that the above matter is fixed for hearing by the Disciplinary Committee of the Legal Practitioners Privilege Committee of the Office of Registrar Supreme Court of Nigeria, Abuja, on June 14, 2019 at 11 a.m. on the forenoon, so at 11 o'clock on the forenoon. Malami will be grilled over a comment he made on Voice of America House of Service on July 13, 2018. Malami accused Dasuke of being responsible for the death of over 100,000 Nigerians during the Goodluck Jonathan government, and that he would not be released despite several subsisting court orders for his release. Malami said, "Remember, we are talking about a person who was instrumental to the death of over 100,000 people. Are you saying that the rights of one person are more important than the rights of 100,000 who lost their lives?" After the interview, Dasuke's family petitioned the Nigerian Bar Association NBA, praying for an investigation and sanction of the minister for unprofessional conduct and utter disregard for the rule of law. In the petition dated July 23rd, 2018, and received by the NBA the same day, the family wanted Malami to be investigated in the resolve of the federal government not to comply with the bail orders, even as Dasuke remains incarcerated for almost 4 years. Recalling how their son served Nigeria meritoriously for 21 years as a courageous officer in the Nigerian Army, managing director of the Nigerian Security Printing and Minting Company, NSPMC, and later as National Security Advisor to the immediate past administration, they stated that Dasuke in his lifetime had not been convicted of any crime till date. The petition signed by his wife, Hajia Bintu Sambo Dasuke, and his son, Abubakar Atiku Dasuke, and his nephew, Senator Umar Dahiru, explained how the ordeal of Dasuke started when Buhari government came on board with unlawful invasion of his houses in Abuja and Sokoto, during which his vital properties, including vehicles, were carted away by the operatives of the Department of State Security. It chronicled how Dasuke was arraigned before four different high courts and was granted bail by all the judges, insisting that the charges were bailable offenses under the Nigerian law. It added that the Court of Justice of the Economic Community of West African States, ECOWAS, declared the detention of Dasuke as unlawful, null and void, and subsequently ordered his immediate release, in addition to imposing a fine of 15 million naira on the federal government as compensation for the breach of Dasuke's fundamental rights. The family regretted that till date, none of the orders of the high courts and the international court has been obeyed by the federal government. The petition referenced the judgment of Justice Ijeoma Ojukwu on the Federal High Court, which on July 2, 2018, admitted Dasuki to bail upon a discovery that his detention was a breach of the Constitution of the Federal Republic of Nigeria and that of the fundamental right of the ex-NSA. The Dasuki family claimed that upon meeting the bail condition, the warrant of release of Dasuki on bail signed by the court was served on the Director General of DSS and the Attorney General for their compliance with the order of the court. The family, however, informed the NBA in the petition that rather than complying with the order of the court, the AGF, as the chief law officer of the Federation, made an unsolicitory and unprofessional remarks that the order of the court as relates to Dasuki would not be obeyed by the federal government. So now there you have it. That is the position of the Dasuki family. They are taking this this chap to the tribunal, or to the disciplinary body rather, for legal practitioners to be disciplined, the AGF, the former AGF, for unguarded remarks. So now you have this person now making pronouncements outside the core of his remit to effectively state that Dasuki is never going to be released, effectively, is what he's saying, because he's attributing several losses of personnel to Dasuki. So we're talking about chain of command. So if you have a chain of command, anything that happens within your sphere of influence, you then obviously comes under your responsibility. But then you are not then held in physical account of that. Otherwise, nobody would then have or make themselves available as a commander. So if you are a commander of a troop and you send your troop to battle, then within that order that you've given that to your troops to go to battle is an understanding that there will be losses. I have not yet heard of a troop that's been sent to battle that have not suffered any losses, and the commander gives that order, and that order then obviously entails an understanding that there might and almost certainly will be some losses. So if you are then saying then that whatever losses is incurred in the course of a commander carrying out an order which is for the protection of his own country or the interest that he serves, if you are saying that the commander is then held personally liable for this, then really you have nobody in command. But then if you also hold this logic to be true, then you have to hold the chain of command all the way to the very top. But now Dasuki is not the topmost commander, because Dasuki reports to somebody. I'm not sure under what authority the National Security Advisor is. I'm assuming it's part of the defense package, and he will have a lead that he reports to, and then that lead will then report to the vice president, who then reports to the presidency. So if you are then holding Dasuki liable for all these losses that you are claiming he is liable for, then you have to go through that chain of command and hold everybody that is within that chain of command that liable, because it's not just his order, he's following instructions. The people he's instructing are following his instruction, and his instruction are instructions that's given to him from above. So then of course then you have to go and detain Goodluck Jonathan and his deputy. I can't quite remember his name. I think his name is Sambo as well, Sambo something, you know. So you have to go detain them as well, and then of course you have to go and detain the chief of defense staff under the Goodluck Jonathan administration as well, because it's not just Dasuki. Then Dasuki is not the be all and end all. He's not the commander in chief. He's not the head of state. He's an operative within a structure. So if you have found fault to detain him outside of the law, then you have to go outside of the law to detain everybody in that chain of command. But then of course we know that Dasuki is not being detained for anything that is done as a national security advisor under the Goodluck Jonathan regime. We all know that. I don't think there's anybody in Nigeria that does not know that Dasuki is being detained because he he supported a coup that got rid of Malam Buhari and detained Malam Buhari then back in the 80s. And whilst Malam Buhari was detained, I think he probably lost his father or his mother or somebody. And Buhari, of course, we all know, is a very vindictive and a very vengeful and a very wicked man. So he's now using the apparatus of state to fight his own personal vendetta. And this is what the detention of Dasuki is all about, because all of the courts in Nigeria have said release this man on bail. All of the courts internationally, at least within the West African region, have said that release this man on bail. And there's nothing wrong, there's nothing that stops the state from releasing this man on bail. You hold his passport and you make sure that security is monitored heavily. So his movement is restricted, but it's under police watch 24/7. The Nigerian state has the facility to do that, but the fact that they want to detain him and restrict him in detention really as a punitive measure for doing that coup against Buhari is really the point that they're emphasizing, is really the point, is the real object of this exercise. So they are now detaining this guy outside of the law, which then tells you that Nigeria is effectively a lawless country, because if we do not observe the law, or if we do not obey the law, if we do not obey the pronouncement of the court, then we are sitting as ourselves as outside of the law, because the law courts are the custodians of the law and the constitution of the country. So if you are sitting yourself, if you are positioning yourself, even in the United Kingdom, in America, in all of the civilized and uncivilized world, everybody knows that the law is sacrosanct. So you obey the law first, and then whatever action you need to do, you do that within the ambits of the law. But these people are now sitting themselves outside of the law, and this guy has now effectively said that no matter how many court pronouncements releases this guy, they are never going to let him out of detention. So that is now effectively a lawless state. So lawlessness in Nigeria, Sambo Dasuki and Malami, that is the topic of conversation for this video. So come join me in the comment section. Let me know what you are making of all this palaver. But before you come join me in the comment section to share your opinion, click on the red subscribe button so it turns gray. Bell button, that way you are notified every time I drop a video. Then come let me know what you are thinking in the comment section. So I'll leave you here. Meet you in the comment section. But here I say peace.